Harper and Harper Audio present Wind Riders, Whale Song of Puffin Cliff by Jen Marlin. Performed by James Fouhey. A note before we begin. For sketches of the Wind Rider, facts about Iceland, animals, and how to help clean the beach, don't forget to download Enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider, or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/pages/WindRiders4. With special thanks to Erin Faligant. For Stacy and her beloved Whaley. Chapter 1. Sand Crabs and Sea Glass. Sofia swam through the surf, keeping her snorkel above the shallow waves. Reaching down to the seabed, she scooped up stones and shells with her bucket. Then she popped her head out of the water, searching for Max. Her sandy-haired friend was already on the beach, his snorkeling gear resting beside him. "Come see what I found," Max called to her. Sofia raced out of the waves so fast she nearly tripped over her flippers. Max held two clear, sparkling stones in front of his eyes. "One blue eye, one green," he said. "Aren't they beautiful?" He batted his eyelashes. Sofia swatted his shoulder playfully. "That's sea glass. Hey, I wonder if I found any." She dumped out her bucket, searching for colorful bits of glass worn smooth by the churning sea. "A sand dollar," said Max, pointing. "You're rich." Sofia held up the round, white object with the star etched across its top. "I'd take this over a real dollar any day," she said, imagining the tiny sea animal it had once been. She reached for a gray shell in the pile, then froze. The gray shell was moving. Max scooped it up. "A sand crab! Hey, little guy!" The crab's legs tickled his palm. When he set it down, it wiggled its V-shaped antennae and burrowed into the sand. "Cute," said Sofia, pushing her hair out of her eyes. "I've read about sand crabs." "Me too. Well, Grandpa taught me about them." Max lived in Starry Bay with Grandpa, a retired fisherman. He shaded his eyes and searched the marina for their fishing boat, which bobbed gently on the sparkling waves. He had spent almost as much time on that boat as on dry land, and Grandpa had taught him everything he knew about sea creatures. Sofia knew tons about all kinds of animals, though. Her mom was a vet, and she was visiting Starry Bay for the summer with her parents. Just then, Max spotted a bit of orange plastic sticking out of Sofia's shell pile. He reached for the scrap of plastic and groaned. A blue cartoon fish grinned at him from the Bay Fish Grill logo. "Trash," said Sofia, wrinkling her forehead. Max nodded. "Plastic from a fast food restaurant. There's way too much of it in the ocean." Sofia jumped to her feet. "Let's recycle it." She grabbed the plastic and waddled toward the nearest recycling bin, not even pausing to take off her flippers. When she got back, Max pointed out a frosted white triangle in her shell pile. "You did find some sea glass." "It looks like ice," said Sofia. But as she held up the glass, a seagull swooped down and snatched it from her fingertips. "Hey," she cried. Instead of flying away with its prize, the gull landed nearby and dropped the sea glass in the sand. Then it swiveled its white head, staring at them with dark, mysterious eyes. "It's our seagull," Max whispered, excitement tingling down his spine. The gull showed up and it was time for another adventure on Wind Rider, a magical sailboat that they had found hidden in the mangrove forest beside the beach. Sofia leaped up. "Let's get to the boat," she cried. "Wait," said Max, laughing. "Don't you want to take off your duck feet?" Sofia glanced down.
"Oh, ha."
She kicked off her flippers and quickly got dressed. Then she sprinted after the gull along the beach toward the boardwalk that led to the mangrove forest. As she stepped into the cool, damp forest, shadows crisscrossed her path. She pushed through tangled leaves and branches until she reached the clearing where she knew Windrider lay waiting. The old sailboat rested like a beached whale, half in the water and half out. Its weathered boards had faded to gray, and its tattered sail waved gently, as if greeting Sofia. When Max caught up to her, he sighed happily. Windrider looked like a wrecked old boat, but Max knew better. He and Sofia had sailed to faraway places on this magical boat. Windrider always returned them right here to the mangrove forest, with no time having passed, as if they'd never been gone at all. But oh, the adventures they'd had! "Caw!" the seagull cried from the broken deck rail. Max laughed. "All right already," he said. "We're coming!" Sofia scampered up the ladder and onto the deck ahead of him. She followed the gull until it landed on the helm, an old wooden steering wheel. The moment Max joined Sofia and placed his hand on the helm, the wind picked up. Leaves swirled and branches creaked. Overhead, the tattered sails of Windrider began to unfurl.
"I wonder where we're going," said Max.
"Do you think there'll be animals that need our help?" asked Sofia.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.